Mimir, when I was in Asgard, I saw Odin do something to some new Aenri. He seemed kind of mindless until he cast a spell that restored their identity.
Aye, that was his habit, even when they were confined to Valhalla. I think letting them remember themselves was another small way of cheating death any way he could. Though I wouldn't be surprised if with that small gift of autonomy, he also embeds an undying personal loyalty to himself. Pass open. That dragon is shaking in its scaly boots, I suspect.
Once we approach the dragon, we will kill or be killed. Understood?
Yes, Father. Come on!
Focus up!
Let's go!
I'll say. That ogre's not getting up anytime soon either.
I can hear the animals. They're relieved. Maybe they'll come out of hiding.
So, father's new spear, it's made out of a ring?
Drop me an eye. Forged by the Huldra brothers as a gift for Odin.
How's it work?
Every so often, the Dropnir drips out identical copies of itself. The Huldras presumably figured that if one golden ring was a good gift, an infinite number of them would earn them a permanent place in Odin's heart.
But it didn't.
Not even a little.
Back at the plains. Looks a lot nicer with the water flowing again.
Brother, somewhere out there there's a riddle you'd enjoy, and I'm going to find it.
Do not.
Once spoken, instantly broken. What am I?
Silence.
Correct!
I was not answering the riddle.
Ah.
Another.
Burnt flesh. It's close. If one rock moves, I'll be ready.
I can sharpen that axe if you want. Living whetstone, that's me. Keep her sharp and she'll keep you alive. You make up your mind. Want a yep before you head off? Let's do it. That'll mess some folks up. Feeling violent. Now, what else was there?
Mimir, wouldn't you prefer to face forward rather than backward?
Careful, brother. We go down there and we're asking for a fight. That Dreki won't take kindly to us just passing through.
Ready.
We fought Valkyrie. How bad could another Dreki be?
Help them!
You know, I really miss the nice dragons from Midgard.
There can't be many more dragons left now.
Then what are we waiting for?
I live to drink another day. Well, in Folkvanger at least. Now I can meet my friend and make amends.
You owe us a story first.
Yes. I remember now. On the day the valley was destroyed, Thor was swinging his hammer wildly through town. Everyone was terrified. Then, a fair-haired warrior stepped in his path, and a fight began. She was a brave woman.
This fair-haired warrior must have been Fae, brother.
Yeah, Mom stood up to Thor.
I'm not sure if Fae had bravery or bravado. Not many live to tell the tale of a fight with Thor.
Fae never spoke to fight with him.
Everyone has secrets.
We do not know for certain this was Fae.
Aye, there is only one way to find out, brother. Another one of those mysterious crystals.
Stay alert.
Aye. Some rocks are not like the others.
Heal yourself.
Nasty hit! You all right, brother?
Start!
now, life in this valley can flourish again.
I'm sure Anvari would be happy we killed another one, at least.
Anvari? The dwarf who put his soul into a ring?
That's right. He created the Soul Eaters. Whatever happened to the annoying bugger anyway?
I lent him to Sindri and he said he lost him.
Lost him.
Mimir, I know this sounds weird, but can you tell me again what happens when someone dies?
Every living thing has a soul, and every soul has four parts. Form, mind, direction, and luck. Direction steers the souls of giants, dwarves, elves, and animals toward the Lake of Souls in Alfheim. But all the parts may be absorbed back into Alfheim's great light.
Stay alert. Say they are close.
We gotta stop their dark magic. Feel more at ease as they're dying. Kinda creepy.
Anything illuminating?
Help them!
Got it.
I'm back. Don't mind me. I know you don't want me around.
I did not say that.
You don't need to. The boss sends me out the most often, and I know why. I'm unbearable. That's why you hate me.
You are not my enemy. You are irrelevant. A stranger.
So, you don't despise me?
I do not feel one way or the other.
That's honestly kind of a relief. I mean, yeah! You're a stranger to me, too. But why should I care what you think?
Now you understand.
Fantastic, Master Kratos. I'm glad to know we do not care about each other. Get bent!
I don't know if that was necessarily the best lesson, but, what do I know?
Spring. I can do something inside of it. I'm under it. I'm trapped. That eye bend. The ridge. Leaning on it.
We will stop it.
Hey, look. A metal plate with glowy runes. Weird, right?
Ah. Two lit springs, two lit runes. Might be connected.
This place has looked better. Sure, I'm open. Wait, feels like there was something else. Yeah? About time I had something to do.
Thank you.
won't get so much as a paper cut in that. Hitting the road or chewing the fat?
Learn anything?
Mimir. If I hadn't accidentally put Fenrir's soul into my knife, he would have gone to the light of Alfheim when he died, right?
Aye. Were he a god or a human who died in battle, a Valkyrie would have taken him to Valhalla or Folkbomber. Had he been a human or god who died outside of battle, he'd been cast down to Helheim. Fenrir was a wolf, so his soul would have joined all the others in Alfheim.
Like mothers.
Yes. Like your mothers.
Grace battle that grave will provide.